Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. All praise is due to Allah, the Rahman and the Rahim. And may Allah's peace and salutations be upon the one that has been sent, Rahmatan lil Alameen, and upon all those who follow them until Yawm al-Din. As to what follows, today inshaAllah ta'ala we are still continuing discussing Allah's names and attributes. And the name that I will do today is Allah's name Al-Fattah and also Khayrul Fatiheen. Allah's name Al-Fattah and Khayrul Fatiheen. And of course both of these have similar meanings. And the name Al-Fattah actually only occurs once in the Quran. Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in Surah Saba, قُلْ يَجْمَعُ بَيْنَنَا رَبُّنَا ثُمَّ يَفْتَحُ بَيْنَنَا بِالْحَقِّ وَهُوَ الْفَتَّاحُ الْعَلِيمُ. That say to them that Allah will bring us together and then He will يَفْتَحُ بَيْنَنَا بِالْحَقِّ. He will open up to us with truth. Now the meaning of يَفْتَحُ بِالْحَقِّ over here means, as we'll talk about, to judge with truth, for indeed Allah is Al-Fattah Al-Alim. And in another verse, Allah Azza wa Jalla says that He is خَيْرُ الْفَاتِحِينَ, or the best of those who perform the verb فَتَح. So what exactly is فَتَح? Well, all of you who know Arabic, you know that فَتَح means to open. فَتَح الْبَاب, to open the door. And we call the instrument that we use to open the door, we call it miftah. The key that opens the door is miftah. And miftah and fatah, of course, all of these occur very commonly in the Quran and Sunnah. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah has given me the miftah of speech, of eloquence. Allah has given me the miftah of balagha. And in one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah placed the mafatih of the treasures of the heavens and earth, and He offered them to me, and I turned them down. So the mafatih is the keys to the treasures. And fatah, therefore, means number one, an opening. That's one meaning. But number two, it also means a victory. Because when you are stuck, you're closed. When you are surrounded by an enemy, you're trapped. So what is a victory? A victory is that opening is given. So one of the primary meanings of fatah in the classical Arabic is victory. And we know this from the Quran itself in Surah Al-Fatah. The beginning of Surah Al-Fatah is what? Inna fatahna laka fatham mubina. We have given you the clear victory. So the fatah over here also means victory. A third meaning of fatah is judgment. A third meaning of fatah is judgment, because when you don't have a decree, you're stuck. When the judgment comes, when the decree comes, this is an opening. So fatah also means to judge, to decree. And this is why the day of judgment is called Yawm al-Fatah, the day of fatah. And here fatah means decree and judgment, because on that day all judgment will occur. And so Allah is Al-Fattah, and He is the best of fatiheen. That وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْفَاتِحِينَ, as Allah says, you are the best of those who perform fatah. Now when we say decree, we have to be very careful here, because Allah's decree is of two types. This is a little bit advanced theology, but it's interesting as well. Allah's qadr and fatah is of two types. Allah's decree is of two types. The first decree is a religious decree. Allah has decreed that He should be worshipped alone. That's a decree. The second decree is a natural or a kawni decree that Allah has legislated. Allah has decreed so and so will live for 70 years. The two decrees are not the same, because the first decree is Allah's will, but Allah Azza wa Jal chooses some people to follow that will and some don't follow it. When Allah decrees none shall be worshipped other than Him, do some people worship other than Allah? Yes. That is Allah's decree, but it is what we call the shar'i decree. There is another decree, the kawni or the natural decree. And the natural decree is effective in His creation. Allah decrees so-and-so is a Muslim, he's going to be a Muslim. Allah decrees so-and-so has 70 years, he has 70 years. The two decrees are different types of decrees. And Allah is Fattah because both decrees belong to Him. So He has the shar'i decree. And the shar'i decree, He decides what is halal, what is haram. He decides who's going to heaven, who's going to hell. And He has the kawni decree. And the kawni decree, He decides our life, our schedules, what we have, what we don't have. This is the kawni decree. And Allah is Al-Fattah. Both of these decrees go back to Him. So of the meanings of Fattah, therefore, are the one who opens up the doors of His decree on us. So the Fattah, The one who opens up the doors of his decree on us. As Allah says, مَا يَفْتَحِ اللَّهُ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ رَحْمَةٍ فَلَا مُمْسِكَ لَهَا. Whatever Allah opens up of the decrees of rahmah, so the Fattah opens the doors of rahmah, no one can stop Allah's rahmah from reaching. وَمَا يُمْسِكْ فَلَا مُرْسَلَ لَهُ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. And whatever Allah shuts off, because the one who opens can also close. The one who opens can also close. وَمَا يُمْسِكْ فَلَا مُرْسِلَ لَهُ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. If the doors are closed, no one can release what is behind the doors. So the Fattah controls those doors. And Allah chooses what to give His creation. And when Allah opens a door, nothing can come between you and what is behind that door. And when Allah shuts a door, then no matter what you do, you will never be able to reach what is behind the door. So look at how many doors has Allah opened for us. Allah has opened the door of mercy. Allah has opened the door of rizq. Allah has opened the door of money. Allah has opened the door of peace and tranquility. Allah has opened the door of family. Allah has opened the door of a society that we live in. All of these are doors that the Fattah has opened and given us. And that is why Allah says, وَعِنْدَهُ مَفَاتِحُ الْغَيْبِ لَا يَعْلَمُهَا. Allah has the keys of all that is hidden. He chooses to give and He chooses to keep. And no one knows other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Fattah is the one who gives you what you want by giving you the keys and opening the doors. The Fattah decrees how you will get it, when you will get it, and what procedure you will get it in. The Fattah is the one who chooses which door to open, at what time, and how much to give of those mafatih al-ghayb, of those keys that unlock the treasures. This is the Fattah. And that is why Allah Azza wa Jal's name Al-Fattah is used at every time of difficulty, at every time when we feel we're surrounded, at every time when our hearts are trembling, when we don't know how to get out of that situation, the Fattah will open the door for us. And that's why Allah says, whoever truly puts his trust and yaqeen in Allah, Allah will make a way out for him, even from places he did not expect. Now we also have to point out the flip side, that sometimes Allah opens the door and we think it might be mercy, but it is not mercy. That we think it might be benefit, but it is a test. It is a fitna. So the Fattah can also open doors that are tests. And Allah mentions this in the Quran. With regards to one civilization that was destroyed, Allah says, فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ فَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَبْوَابَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. When they turned away from worshipping Allah, we opened up the doors of everything. فَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَبْوَابَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Meaning what? They got money and wealth and power and status, and they felt deceived that Allah loves us. And they became غُرُور. They became arrogant in these blessings. Then Allah said, ثُمَّ أَخَذْنَاهُمْ بَغْتَةً. We took them all of a sudden. This is like Fir'aun. This is like the Haman, the Qaruns. These are the people. Allah is Fattah to them, but not the way we want. Allah opens up the doors, but as a test and as a punishment. So not everything that Allah opens will be of immediate benefit. It could also be a trial. It could also be a test. So Al-Fattah, and when it comes to Allah, what does it mean? Number one, that all doors are opened up. The doors of good and the doors of the opposite of good. Number two, that Allah is the judge. So Al-Fattah is the best judge. And one of the names of the Day of Judgment is Yawm Al-Fatah. And Allah says that قُلْ يَوْمَ الْفَتْحِ لَا يَنْفَعُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِمَانُهُمْ. On the day of Fatah, on the day of judgment, the people who didn't believe, their iman will be of no use on that day. So the Yawm Al-Fatah is the day of judgment. Number three, the Fattah is the one whom you call at times of distress. And he shall open the door for you to get you out of your distress. Inna fatahna laka fatham mubina. We have opened up for you the manifest victory. Wa ukhra tuhibbunaha nasrun min Allahi wa fathun qareeb wa bashshiril mu'mineen. Another blessing Allah says that you love, I will give you victory and a fatah that is very close. And that is something that we can give glad tidings to the believers. And number four, that Allah Allah opens up difficulties, that Allah makes the constricted vast, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps you when you don't know where else to turn. And there is a famous narration in Bukhari, a very long story of a sahabi who was stuck in a very difficult predicament. And if he continued, it's a long story, but he was going to be punished for something that he didn't do. And he made dua to Allah and he said, Allahumma ftah alayya. Oh Allah, open up for me the doors of your mercy. And because of his dua, Allah revealed verses in Surah An-Nur that we recite to this day in his case that cleared him from the charge, that made him free and innocent. Otherwise, long story, but he was going to be punished for something. Then Allah Azza wa Jal revealed laws specifically for this case. And because he used the name Fattah and he invoked Allah's Fatah, Allah revealed Quran that we recite to this day. So this is a name that we can use to come closer to Allah when we need Allah's rahmah, Allah's mercy. And of course, this is why when we enter the masjid, what is the dua we say when we enter the masjid? Allahumma ftah li abwaab rahmatik. This is where Allah's rahmah is manifest. So before we enter the masjid, that's the dua that we are commanded to make. Oh Allah, open up for me the doors of your mercy. And we have so many instances in the Quran, time is limited, but the beautiful story of Nuh alayhi salam, for 950 years, his qawm rejected him, his qawm mocked him, his people ridiculed him, his people tried to kill him, and finally he raised his hands up to Allah and he made dua to Allah that iftah bayni wa baynahum fathan, that oh Allah, open up the victory between me and them, give me a fatah over them. And so that one dua, what did Allah do? Fafatahna abwab as-sama'i bima'in munhamir. Allah opened up the doors of the heavens and water came the likes of which humanity has never seen. And Allah opened up the doors of the earth and water gushed up the likes of which humanity has never seen. And the great flood, that flood which is believed in by every single civilization and every remnant of humanity, has some myth and some theory and some story of a great flood. That flood that occurred because Nuh alayhi salam invoked the Fatah and he said, oh Allah, open up the doors against my enemy. And so Al-Fatah responded to that dua in a manner that humanity has never seen before and after. And Shu'aib as well, Rabbana ftah bayni wa baynahum fathan wa najjini wa man ma'i min al-mu'minin. Shu'aib made the same dua and others as well. So the bottom line, the name of Allah Al-Fattah should cause our yaqeen, our tawakkul in Allah to reach unlimited heights. Allah is the one who can help when nobody else can help. Allah is the one who can grant when nobody else can grant. Allah has the keys, mafatih al-ghayb, that nobody has. There is no impossibility for Allah. Al-Fattah can make a way out for us. So the name of Allah Al-Fattah is a name we can use for every troublesome situation, for every worrisome problem. Allah Azza wa Jal can make the impossible possible, and he can make every difficulty easy. And that is why we conclude with this dua. One of the duas of the Prophet ﷺ was, Allahumma la sahla illa ma ja'altahu sahlan wa anta idha shi'ta taj'alu al-hazana sahlan. Oh Allah, nothing is easy except whatever you make easy, and you can make any difficulty easy. Oh Allah, make my difficulty and my trouble easy. This is the Fattah, the one who can make every difficulty easy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our difficulties and make us safe from our pains and suffering, and open up us for the doors of mercy and his rahmah. And inshallah we will continue the day after tomorrow. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.